Ever wondered about what school would be like with no grades? We did. Punahou's freshman English 1 courses this year are not using grades, so Punavision visited to find out how it is all going.
Well, for me, it's been something that I've cared about for a long time. I think in many ways the sort of education system is broken.
They give you a letter grade and they don't really look at how you did your work. They just are like, okay, you got the answer, you're good. Like, and maybe you made a mistake in your work and you got all the steps right, but you just put a wrong sign and you got the question completely wrong.
I feel like letter grades just kind of add stress on something to be ranked like that.
What we've done with grades has, I think, become really unhealthy for students in that we report on student learning using the language really that colleges use for admissions. I would call grades the coin of the realm at school in that they become essentially a currency that students need to earn for college entrance.
I think that feedback is a better way to stimulate revising versus letter grades, which don't.
The aims of the poetry drama course are critical thinking, collaboration, and persistence and resilience. We break critical thinking down into essentially metacognition and then the kind of analysis that one's going to be doing with poetry and drama. We look at certain collaborative behaviors and outcomes and then once again describe what we are asking students to work on doing as they grow their persistence and or their abilities to persist and their resilience within.
I think that it kind of helps me to move forward without thinking in like numbers or grades. So it's helping more than traditional school does, and it's more of like what school is supposed to be like.
It encourages me to revise my work and look for ways that I can improve versus just the first time doing the best I can and then like stopping there.
I do get the feeling though that students are wondering what's going to happen. There certainly could be some who are a little concerned and worried about this letter that'll come out of left field, whether or not it counts.
I think it's very different from what I'm used to. Like, I'm not really sure if I like it too much because, like, I don't know what I'm getting until the end, but it definitely takes a lot of the stress off.
I mean, it causes me less stress, actually. Instead of being graded for everything I do, like, under strict criterion. I feel like there's criterion still, but it's feedback.
So what we've come up with, we use the language of competencies, which has its problems, but for now that's what we're using. And we're working to describe very clearly and very specific, precisely, what students need to do to evolve toward and grow toward those aims, but not then boiling all of that language down to a single symbol.
I wish that maybe some middle school classes had it, because then I would probably know how to rate myself better on the feedback scale.
I mean, to be honest, I hope this and the work that Punahou and Dr. McCarron is doing with a larger group called the Mastery Transcript Consortium, I hope that what that does is just upend the world of education completely. Think big.
I personally like the way that we're being graded in English without letter grades.
And there will be a grade that matters or that counts or that will be used as currency in 3.5 years when my freshmen now are applying to college. The fact that that's coming, I know, has to be addressed, and there's some communication that we've got a couple months to work on so that these two systems can come as close to being in sync as possible.